वेलकम बैक वंस अगेन टू माई ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल इंग्लिश बाई प्रीति भारद्वाज। आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द पोयम डैड एंड द कैट एंड द ट्री रिटन बाय किट राइट फ्रॉम योर टेक्स्ट बुक हनी कॉम। सो लेट अस हैव अ लुक एट द टेक्स्ट ऑफ द पोयम एंड द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ इट्स स्टैंजास वन बाय वन। द पोयम गोज लाइक, दिस मॉर्निंग अ कैट गॉट स्टक इन आवर ट्री। Dad said, "Right, just leave it to me." The tree was wobbly, the tree was tall. Mum said, "For goodness sake, don't fall." Now here, the poet has introduced us with a cat, okay, and his dad and his mother. Now the poet here is telling us that one morning what happened, that a cat got stuck on a tree, okay. So the dad decided that he will take out the cat from that tree. But the tree on which the cat got stuck was wobbly. Wobbly here means that the tree was shaking. Okay, but the tree was tall as well. So the mother of the poet was concerned for the father. So she said that, for goodness sake, don't fall. So the mother here is asking to the father to be careful so that while taking down the cat from the tree, he will not hurt himself. Okay. Further it goes like, fall, scoffed dad. A climber like me, child's play this is, you wait and see. He got out the ladder from the garden shed. It slipped, he landed in the flower bed. Now further, when the mother was asking the father to be careful, the father started laughing. He said, fall, scoffed dad. Here the word scoffed means to laugh. Okay, so at this the father started laughing, saying that it is a small matter for him to climb on a tree like this. Okay, he said that, a climber like me, child's play this is, you wait and see. For him, this was a child's play to climb on a tree. Now, further what the father did was that he took out the ladder from the garden shed. Okay, and with the help of the ladder, he started climbing the tree. But the moment he started climbing the tree, the ladder got slipped and the father landed in the flower bed. Here, landed in the flower bed means that the father fell down from the ladder and he fell into the flower bed that was there in the garden. Further, the poem goes like, never mind, said dad, brushing the dirt off his hair and his face and his trousers and his shirt. We will try plan B. Stand out of the way. Mum said, don't fall again, okay. Now, as the father has fallen down from the ladder, so that was the plan A of the father in which he got failed. But here he is saying that even after failing in plan A, now I am ready to try plan B. But before going for the plan B, the father was cleaning all his clothes, his shirt, his face and his trousers from the mud that got stuck on his clothes and on his body when he fell down from that ladder. Okay, so the father started cleaning himself. Now he is further saying that, I am going to try plan B, so stand out of my way. It means that please give me the way to move ahead. At this, the mom is again saying to him, don't fall again. Okay, so the mother is again asking him to be careful. Okay, further, fall again, said dad, funny joke. Then he swung himself up on a branch, it broke. Dad landed veloop back onto the deck. Mum said, stop it, you will break your neck. Rubbish, said dad. Now we will try plan C. Easy as winking to a climber like me. Now, after failing in the plan A, the father was determined to try for plan B. Okay, but the mother asked him to be careful. At this, again, father started laughing that this is a very small matter for me. This is a very easy job for me to climb on a tree. So according to the plan B, what the father did was that he climbed up on the tree with the help of a branch. Okay, he took up a branch so that he can climb upon the tree with that. But the moment he decided to hold the branch properly, the branch got broke down. Okay, and again what happened, that the father fell down. Now here, dad landed veloop. Veloop here means to strike heavily with a very loud sound. So what happened exactly was that the branch got broke off, because of which the father landed again onto the land with a very loud sound. Okay, back to the deck here means flat surface. So the dad was again there on the ground. Okay, he fell down from the tree. Mom said, stop it, you will break your neck. Again, the mother is asking him to be careful. She is warning him, saying that if he will keep on doing such activities, he is going to break his neck. Okay, at this, what father said was that, rubbish. Now we will try plan C. Easy as winking to a climber like me. So now the father is again determined to go for plan C, and he is again saying that this is a very silly matter for me. This is a very easy job for me, as easy as winking. Now winking here means closing of eyes. So here father is saying, father is comparing climbing on the tree with winking. Okay, so he's comparing climbing on the tree with winking here. In a way, he is trying to say that this is not a big matter for him. This is not a big deal for him. And this is a very simple task, very simple job. Now further, the poem goes like, then he climbed up high on the garden wall. Guess what? He didn't fall. He gave a great leap and he landed flat in the crook of the tree trunk, right on the cat. Now, according to plan C, what father did was that first he climbed up the wall that was there around the tree, the garden wall. Okay, so first he climbed up that high wall, and after climbing up that wall, from there he took a jump. Okay, he took a jump onto the crook of the tree trunk. Okay, now crook here means a curve, a bend. As you can see in the image, that there is a point at which many branches are meeting, and at this point the father has got stuck. He is sitting at this place. So this particular place, which is shown here in the image, where the father is sitting on the tree, is the crook of the tree. Okay, so in this plan C, what father did was that he first climbed up on the garden wall, then from that wall he took a jump, a great leap. Leap here means jump. Okay, he took a great jump and he landed flat in the crook of the tree trunk. Crook here means the curve, the bend. Okay, so the father got landed onto the tree safely this time, and he didn't fall this time. Okay, and he landed flat right on the cat. Now further, the cat gave a yell and sprang to the ground, pleased as punch to be safe and sound. The cat gave a yell. Yell here means shout. Okay, so it means that as soon as when the father landed on the tree, the cat started shouting and sprang to the ground. Sprang here means jump. Okay, sprang means jump. So what the cat did was that first it started shouting and then it jumped to the ground. Pleased as punch to be safe and sound. Pleased as punch means very happy. I repeat, pleased as punch here means very happy. So the cat was very happy because she was safe and sound. So this stanza means that the moment the father landed on the tree, the cat first started shouting and then she jumped onto the ground, and she was all safe and sound and very happy. Okay, further, so it's smiling and smirking, smug as can be, but poor old dad's still stuck up the tree. Now at the last of the poem, in the last stanza, it has been told that finally the cat was now out from the tree. It was on the ground where, because she jumped down from the tree. Okay, when the dad got landed onto the tree, now it is smiling and smirking. Smirking means to smile. Okay, so the cat was all smiling and it was smug as can be. Smug means happy. So the cat was very happy because it was safe and sound and it was smiling. But poor old dad's still stuck up the tree. But meanwhile, during this whole procedure of taking down or bringing down the cat from the tree, it was now dad who was there on the top of the tree. And this time it was dad who got stuck up on the tree. Okay. So that's all about this very interesting poem, Dad and the Cat and the Tree. If this video has helped you in understanding this poem better, then please like the video, share it with your friends. In the comment section down below, let me know which topic or chapter you want me to cover next. Subscribe to the channel. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.